I've never seen a shoe like that, man. That's the craziest shoe we've ever seen. Grab it. Let's do a review session with Jay Lando.
What's up? What's good, YouTube? You're with Jay Lando, and welcome to another episode of Review Sessions. Today, we're going to take a look at the Jordan 1 Biohack. Now, this sneaker released September 4th for a retail price of $170. The Biohack pays homage to two separate things. One is the 2005 Nike SB Dunk Mid that released with Undefeated that has the same kind of color palette and a resale value of $1,000 right now. It's about 15 years old, so that's partly why, and also for Dunk fans, it's one of the most coveted sneakers. And I know it's not a Dunk Low, but yet it still has that value. And the second is Jordan Brand's relationship with Tokyo. So this sneaker represents some of that Tokyo nightlife with the neon lights and that great personality that all the Tokyo people have. And if you're new to this channel, definitely hit the subscribe button, smash that thumbs up, hit the notification bell, because I'll be bringing you news and reviews every single week here on the Review Sessions with Jay Lando. Now that we got that out of the way, let's get into some sneakers, baby. So let's get into some details. We have the Nike Classic Retro Jordan 1 box in black and red. That's dope. And I got a clean box, so shout out to Bonobon Shoes. I got this sneaker like the day after release. Sorry it's taking me so long, but I'm backed up with shoes, probably because of Bonobon. So check them out in my descriptions below at their IG handle. And also Brian Lee, thank you for hooking me up with my intro and my Jay Lando logo in the building. Shout out to you, bro. Hit the description below for him because he does great graphic design work. Now on the box, it says Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Baruch Brown, Racer Pink, Black Brune, Baruch, Noir, Rose Carrar. Now, I think that's French. If it is, my French sucks. So pardon my French, no pun intended. But it comes with the second set of laces, which is this Racer Pink, which is always a cool option to have both. And if you really want to get biohack, you throw those on your sneaker. To get into the details of this shoe, we have a top-notch quality suede overlay that runs throughout the majority. It is dope, top-notch, man. They hit a home run with this. So at the top of the toe box, you can see this mint teal color, and it's also on the back of this tab right here. So I wanted to give you guys that look. And for the overlay at the top of the toe box is this navy blue that runs through the eye stays, or the eyelets, excuse me. And for the tongue is this orange tongue with a stitched in Nike Air in Racer Pink. And you can see that it's an exposed tongue. So you can see the inner workings of it. And the inner lining is also Racer Pink, which will match the laces. And for this panel in the mid, it's a nubuck. So watch out because you can get some lint on this thing because I haven't even worn it and I already got some. And the overlay with the Nike swoosh in silver on the back panel for the heel is the Baruch Brown. And at the top of the ankle flap is also in the Baruch Brown with the Jordan wings stamped in there, which is cool. And on the inside of this flap, you can see that it's like this neon yellow green color, which is really cool. And for the midsole is this neon green, but it looks like grass stain green if you ask me. And on the outsole is a classic Jordan 1 black outsole. So this is pretty much the majority of the shoe, you know what I mean? Like, there's no real crazy details. I mean, for this mid panel, you also have the same material right here on the top of the ankle. And that is the Jordan 1 Biohack. My personal thoughts and opinions of the Biohack is it is dope as you guys can fill in the rest with your imagination. But I give this a solid 9 out of 10 on the Landometer. Ding, 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 ding. Solid. The reason why is because of the materials. They just hit a home run. I mean, they need to do this every single time with all Jordans because we pay so much. The quality control, there's very little defects, if any, I've heard of on the internet. And the color scheme works like to a T. The homage that it pays to with undefeated 2005 Nike Dunk SB Mid with the Tokyo Nightlife Neon Light, shout out Tokyo. They just hit a home run. The showing tongue, the neon colors, all of it is super dope. I just love this shoe. What can I say? Now, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, whether it's Jordan 1 ranks this year or, you know, ever for you. And if you were able to get a pair, because you could always hit up Bottom Bunk Shoes. Just letting you know. Now, with that being said, you got Jay Lando, another episode of Review Sessions. I'll see you guys next time. We out. Peace.
Like that, man. That's the craziest shoe we've ever seen. Grab it. Let's do a review session with Jay Lando.